No counting the votes and no announcing the winners. Today, the U.S. Supreme Court temporarily blocked a vote by Native Hawaiians from moving forward. Voting started earlier this month and is supposed to wrap up on Monday. Native Hawaiian voters are choosing 40 delegates to take part in a constitutional convention where the focus will be on self-determination. Today's decision does not stop eligible voters from casting a ballot, but it does put the process on hold. Alex Serbal follows up. Alex.
Aloha, Marissa. Grassroots Institute of Hawaii challenged the election, arguing it's unconstitutional because non-Hawaiians are not allowed to vote. Now, I spoke with the group's president today, and he tells me to exclude others is not in line with the aloha spirit. Native Hawaiians are voting to elect delegates for a convention next year to come up with a self-governance document to be ratified by Native Hawaiians. But Grassroots Institute of Hawaii says the voting process is unconstitutional because it excludes non-Hawaiians. And on Friday, a U.S. Supreme Court justice blocked the counting of votes.
We're very pleased because this is a victory for the aloha spirit in Hawaii. Today's decision by the U.S. Supreme Court means that we're not going to continue dividing people on the basis of race.
We reach out to Na'i Aupuni, the organization coordinating the election, and we also reached out to its attorney. In response to today's decision, the group said, reorganizing a government is not easy, and it takes the courage and will of the candidates to take the first step in this historic process.
Over the past few decades, we've seen a growing trend of tension between Native Hawaiians and the rest of the population. That's very un-Hawaiian because we actually are people of inclusiveness.
In its statement, Na'i Aupuni said it is confident the election will move forward and encourages all voters to continue voting. We also reached out to Big Island rancher Freddie Rice, who sued the state more than 15 years ago for the right to vote in the Office of Hawaiian Affairs election, and won.
What they're trying to do now is against the argument in favor of the Rice case. So then you would have to decide which is constitutional and which isn't. They can't both be because they're opposite.
We also reached out to OHA, but they told me no one would be available for comment. And winners won't be announced until there is further direction from the U.S. Supreme Court. And we will continue to follow the story and bring you those updates as soon as we get them. Alex Serbal, KHON2 News.